Winter solstice is a very important time. This event had been acknowledged as the victory of light over darkness since the earliest known times in civilizations, as it marks the beginning of a. To mark this event, they built magnificent structures with amazing precision. These structures and their construction happened thousands of years ago, makes it hard to understand how and with what tools and technology they could build such majestic and wonderful structures. Let's have a look into a few of them. Newgrange, Ireland. A megalithic passage tomb situated in Newgrange, County Meath, Republic of Ireland. Structure dates back to 3200 BC. This makes it older than the pyramids of Egypt and Stonehenge of England and Wiltshire. Around winter solstice, the sun rays enter as a beam of light in the monument. Direct sunlight can enter for about 17 minutes in the monument. Instead of doorways, they enter through an specially contrived opening known as the roof box above the entrance to illuminate. The roof box. The first rays of the sun enters the passage as a beam and travels up to 19 meters to reach the main chamber. As the sun rises higher, the beam widens and the whole chamber illuminates dramatically. Mnajdra, Malta, southern coast. A Mediterranean island, home to prehistoric megaliths and settlements. Built in 3rd to 4th century BC, this prehistoric structure consists of three conjoined, unconnected temples. These, the upper, middle, and lower temples, were built to mark the position of the rising sun on the first day of each season. Of these, the lowest temple is astronomically aligned. On the equinoxes, the sunlight passes through the main doorway and lights up the major axis. On winter solstice, the sun rays light up the edge of the megalith, which is found along the passage connecting the first pair of chambers to the inner chambers. Stonehenge, England. Built to align with the sun on solstices. It's in ruinous state now. It consists of megaliths as long as 13 feet high, 7 feet wide, and weighing 25 tons. On the summer solstice, the sun rises behind the heel stone in the northeast part of the horizon, and its first rays illuminate the heart of Stonehenge. On winter solstice, the sun sets to the southwest of the stone circle. Karnak Temple, Egypt. Luxor in Egypt witnesses 9 astronomical occurrences. Remarkable is the sun alignment on winter solstice in the Temple of Karnak. On winter solstice, the sun enters the temple from the eastern entrance, its beam shining on the temple's main axis, entering the Holy of Holies shrine, which housed God Amun's statue. At midday, the sun illuminates the Sacred of Holies for some time before lighting across the holy places. Goseck Circle, Germany. Its construction has been carbon dated to 4900 BC. On winter solstice, the sun rises in alignment with the southeast gate and sets behind the southwest gate. Its existence was made public in 2003. It was opened to public in 2005. Machu Picchu, Cusco, Peru. In Inca times, winter solstice was known as Inti Reme, or the Festival of Sun. At this time, at dawn, when the very first ray of sun arises over the distant mountains, it shines through one of two windows of the Temple of the Sun. Thereafter, it illuminates the ceremonial stone inside. The most important building, Torreon, was placed inside the Temple of Sun. Torreon is a rare example of curved Inca architecture. Besides, there is an enormous ceremonial stone called Intihuatana. It casts no shadow on this particular day only. We will discuss the other amazing ancient structures that aligned perfectly with sun on various occasions in the other videos.